Okay, as I say, she woke me up in the morning and said,
Get up, Art.
You've got a record date.
It's at Contemporary, 2 o'clock, with Miles Davis's rhythm section. It's all set.
Oh my God, what did you do?
I just flipped out because I hadn't been playing or been practicing or anything, and I hadn't touched my horns, and all I'd been doing at the time was using about a half an ounce of heroin a day. Her and Les Koenig from Contemporary Records have set it up because they knew that no matter how strung out I was, that I would take care of business if I knew that people were depending on me. You know, even at my worst, I was always that way. I wanted to be respected. Evidently, the last time I had played, I'd been loaded or something, and I had left the mouthpiece on the neck. I looked down at the end of the neck and there was nothing but just metal. I had ripped the cork off and the cork was stuck in my mouthpiece. Like if I wasn't in tune, or if it started pulling loose or like slipping or something, I was dead or leaking. You know, there was nothing I could do about it. So not only was I going to be rusty, not having played or anything, and have to all of a sudden play with Miles Davis's rhythm section, they play every single night, like 4 and 5 hours a night, and everything under the tip of their fingers, you know, in their minds, you know, like masters, practicing masters. From me, like hiding in a little beat pad up on the second steepest hill in L.A., like sitting in a chair with just burn marks all over the floor and the chair and the couch, sitting there with a bloody glass full of bloody water, you know, and just doing nothing but fixing and just being a complete derelict, like a total withdrawal from any and all reality and all things, human or otherwise, you know, hopefully. And music is like a thing of, it's so technical and so difficult that you just can't play it unless you play it all the time. You know, it's like being a professional basketball player or something. You know, if you don't play for 6 months, you can't all of a sudden just go in the game and play. You know, it's just, it's almost impossible. You know? And I realized that that's what I had to do, is the impossible, you know. I remember at the beginning of this book that you asked me if I were a genius, you know, and I attempted to answer yes, and why, you know, and this was one of the greatest examples of my genius. Like, no one else could have done it, I don't think, at all, you know, unless a person, like, as steeped in the genius role as I am, you know, and will be, you know. And, yeah, and will always be, and I've always been. Yeah, born, you know, bred, and, you know, raised like, you know, like nothing but a total genius, you know. So I knew that I could do anything. There's nothing that I couldn't do. You know? Yeah, and
the only thing,
I was terrified.
Now you take care of him.